Dear athletes, dear friends, competing at the Olympic Games is, as we all know, the dream of every athlete. As an Olympian, I clearly remember the excitement and anticipation when you are nominated to compete in the Olympic Games. And as you can see, this is just a very short time ago. Whether it is your first time at the Olympic Games, or if you already are an Olympian, you can be sure that the Olympic Winter Games PyeongChang 2018 will be an unforgettable experience. As you begin your preparations, this video will give some useful tips and insights on what you can expect as an athlete at the Olympic Winter Games PyeongChang 2018. Here to guide you on this journey are members of the IOC Athletes Commission. They are all Olympians themselves, so you will get a real insider's perspective on how to make the most of this fantastic Olympic experience.
The Olympic Winter Games, PyeongChang 2018, and the most amazing sporting event on the planet. From the 9th to the 25th of February 2018, you are going to participate in and witness an incredible Olympic Winter Games in the Republic of Korea. Taking place in the beautiful surroundings of PyeongChang, these are the first Olympic Winter Games to take place in Asia since Nagano 1998 in Japan. Located in East Asia, the Republic of Korea has a population of over 51 million, while its vibrant capital, Seoul, is home to more than 10 million people.
PyeongChang, a county with a population of 43,000, is known as Happy 700 PyeongChang because its location is 700 meters above sea level, which is considered ideal for well-being. Winter conditions are great in the mountains, where resorts aspire to become known as the Alps of Asia.
Around 2,900 athletes are expected to compete in PyeongChang in seven sports comprising 15 disciplines and 102 events. This is an additional four events compared to the Olympic Winter Games in Sochi. The Olympic Winter Games PyeongChang 2018 will feature the highest number of women's and mixed events, the highest gender equality in Olympic Winter Games, and the highest number of female athletes.
Together with our IOC colleagues, international federations, and national Olympic committees, we have been visiting PyeongChang over the past 5 years to help make sure that you have the best possible conditions and environment to compete at your peak.
And so we want to introduce you to the journey you'll be taking from the time you arrive in the Republic of Korea until the end of the Games. It's going to be an incredible journey, and this is a preview of what you can expect.
You come into the Olympics and you for sure want to win the medal. But the Olympics is so much more. There are so many athletes from different countries around the world, and then you see the happiness just from all the competitors, all the athletes just being there and getting in that Olympic feeling.
일단 운동 선수로서는 누구나 꿈꾸는 올림픽이기 때문에 이루게 된 꿈이었기 때문에 정말 평생의 기억에 남고 선수로서 가장 자부심을 느낄 만한 그런 경험이었던 것 같습니다.
And so, we begin with the journey. With your arrival, Seoul Incheon International Airport and Yangyang International Airport near PyeongChang are the two official ports of entry for the Games, with the main Seoul Incheon International Airport being located about 240 kilometers west of PyeongChang.
As well as being your accreditation for the Games, together with a valid passport, the pre-valid Olympic identity and accreditation card also serves as the entry document into the Republic of Korea at Games time and avoids you having to carry a regular entry visa.
From the moment you arrive in the Republic of Korea, your accreditation card will have to be around your neck at all times, except when you compete. It will give you access to your competitions and the training venues, the Olympic Village, and all services needed.
PyeongChang is directly connected to Seoul by the East-West Yeongdong Expressway. Dedicated buses will take you to your first point of arrival at PyeongChang 2018, the two Olympic villages at the Gangneung Coastal Cluster and the PyeongChang Mountain Cluster.
The Olympic Village will be the place for you to rest, relax, recover, and prepare yourself for the culmination of your four-year journey.
The PyeongChang Olympic Village lies in the heart of the mountains, whilst the Gangneung Coastal Cluster lies half an hour away near the Gangneung Olympic Park.
All the resources and services at the Olympic Villages have been designed to make sure that you can perform to the very best of your abilities, recognizing that athletes are at the heart of the Olympic Games. So let's show you some of the key facilities that you'll be experiencing in the PyeongChang 2018 Olympic Villages.
The heart of the Olympic Village is the residential zone. This is where you'll be eating, sleeping, chilling out, and recovering.
The main dining hall is just what you expect, massive. It's open 24 hours free of charge, with a quality food service suitable for high-level competitive athletes. It has a wide variety of food for different cultural and religious groups, as well as nutritional variety.
Each of the Olympic villages has a polyclinic for the diagnosis, treatment, and recovery of athletes, as well as an anti-doping station.
During the period of the Olympic Games, any participating athlete may be tested at any time, in any location, anywhere in the world. The IOC will use all possible location information on all athletes, such as training and competition times, arrivals and departures, accreditation details, and rooming lists. Some athletes may need to take some medication for genuine medical reasons and where no permitted alternative is available. These athletes require a TUE or therapeutic use exemption. Please contact your NOC for more information.
It's extremely important to fill out your whereabouts forms. Failing to do so is equivalent of a no-show and can lead to a violation of the anti-doping code.
You'll also be able to meet with the IOC safeguarding officer in the polyclinics to learn about the Games Time IOC safeguarding program and its reporting procedure, as well as the IOC Prevention of Harassment and Abuse in Sport initiatives. Each Olympic village also has a recreational gym and pretty cool recreational areas, like the entertainment zone. And not to worry, there'll be free Wi-Fi throughout the village. A multi-faith center will be made available in both Olympic villages and are open to athletes of all faiths. These centers are dedicated to worship and meditation.
You will also find both Olympic villages and an Olympic truce mural. Athletes and officials at each edition of the Games are invited to show their support for peace and solidarity by signing the mural. Signing it is a symbolic gesture through which you commit to acting as peace ambassadors. We know that sport alone cannot enforce or maintain peace, but it has a vital role to play in building a better and more peaceful world. The experience that you will live during the Olympic Games and at the Olympic Village will show the world that competition and respect go together, and that the Olympic spirit overcomes barriers as well as unites people and promotes tolerance and friendship.
Additionally, the IOC will create a mourning place within the PyeongChang Olympic Village. The chosen spot will allow Olympic Village residents to mourn those who have passed away in a calm and dignified way. There will be an inter-village shuttle bus available for those staying at the Gangneung village.
There will be approximately 14,000 accredited media in PyeongChang, made up of 3,000 written and photographic press and 11,000 broadcasters. The media will include sport and news reporters, photographers, and broadcasters from every country represented at the Olympic Games. It's their job to report on the Olympic Games, capturing what happens on the field of play, including your performances, and then deliver it to the world, these reports via television, newspapers, magazines, digital, and social media platforms. You and the media will be able to interact and hold interviews in a number of dedicated locations. The primary interactions will be through flash interviews of a minute or two in a mix zone. A mix zone is an area where media can interview as you leave the field of play. Mix zones are established at every competition venue and official training venue. It's a requirement that every athlete leaves the field of play through the mix zone at official practice sessions and competition. Though it is not a requirement for you to speak with the media if you don't wish to, however, you should keep in mind that the media have an important role to play in publicizing your achievements and your sport. Press conferences at competition venues. Venue press conferences are generally only used as a formal conclusion with the medaling athletes or teams. Press conference at the main press center. NOCs will often book press conferences rooms at the main press center, located in Alpensia. Firstly, prior to the opening ceremony to introduce their athletes and teams to the media, and then following athletes winning medals. Longer interviews, usually coordinated by your NOC press attaché at the International Broadcast Center, located as well in Alpensia, the main press center, or at the Olympic Village in the Village Media Center. Your best point of contact at all times is your NOC press attaché. They are your designated NOC media counterpart who will look after all media matters for you so you can do what you came to do, compete. Furthermore, as an athlete competing at the Olympic Winter Games PyeongChang 2018, you are encouraged to share your experiences with your friends, family, and supporters via social and digital media. IOC social and digital media guidelines have been designed to ensure these activities respect the Olympic values and the rights of others. These guidelines apply to all accredited persons at the Games, including you, athletes. The four main principles that you should keep in mind are the following. 1. Your post must not be made for the purposes of demonstration or any form of political, religious, or racial propaganda. They must respect the law, be dignified, and not be discriminatory, offensive, or defamatory. 2. The use of social and digital media must not be for any commercial, promotional, or advertising purposes. In addition, selling or commercially distributing any still photographs, audio, or video taken or recorded in Olympic venues is prohibited. 3. The capture of still photographs of events, competitions, or any other activities is allowed, and such pictures can be shared on your own social and digital media accounts for personal, non-commercial, and non-promotional use. 4. The capture of audio video from the events, competitions, or any other activities which occurs at Olympic venues, including the Olympic Village, is allowed. However, you are not allowed to share any audio video content that includes images of ceremonies, competitions, or back of house on social and digital media. This means, for example, that you can't post on your social media account any video which includes visions of competition event or from behind the scenes in the marshalling area. Each NOC may also issue additional guidelines related to the use of social and digital media, and we advise that you contact your NOC to confirm its position.
All athletes competing at the Games will receive the latest Samsung smartphone. Don't forget to claim yours at the Olympic Village.
Check with your NOC or at the Samsung Galaxy Studio at the Olympic Village for further details about your Samsung smartphone. Each of your complimentary smartphones will have an Athlete 365 app. The Athlete 365 will be a great resource for athletes at PyeongChang 2018. So if you have a question at the Games about transport, venue, food, or accommodation,
go to the Athlete 365.
If you want to share your experiences and connect with fellow elite athletes across the world,
go to the Athlete 365.
Looking to brush up on your skills to build a career after sport?
Go to the Athlete 365.
Want to find out how other athletes are managing the transition from pitch to profession? Access exclusive offers from the IOC and its partners. Find out inside information created by athletes for athletes. Or check out the latest job opportunities tailored for elite performers.
Yes, you've got it. Go to the Athlete 365. As far as attending the competitions, everyone at the IOC Athletes Commission and the PyeongChang Organising Committee have worked really hard and worked together to make sure that you, athletes, can watch your own discipline using your Olympic identity and accreditation card. In addition, you will also have access to all outdoor venues using your accreditation. To attend different disciplines taking place in an indoor venue, you will need to request complimentary tickets from your NOC at the NOC office at the Olympic Village.
Each Olympic Village also has the Athlete 365 space, located at the entrance of the dining hall. It's here that you'll be able to meet with the IOC Athletes Commission and vote for two new members.
The Athletes Commission represents the voice of athletes within the Olympic movement. Our mission is to ensure that the athlete's viewpoint remains right at the heart of the Olympic movement. So please, come here and share your thoughts. It's also the place at games time where you can relax and watch your fellow athletes compete on screen. So come and check it out. Within the residential zone, you'll also find the studio where all athletes will be asked to pose for headshots, which will be used for sports presentations.
The Olympic Village Plaza is where a lot of useful services can be found. Cafes, banks, ATMs, a post office, a beauty salon, general store. After all, this is going to be your home away from home.
The Olympic Village Plaza is also the only area where media can enter into the Olympic Village, except for two special days where media will be invited into the residential zone to report on the life at the Olympic Village. This is also where the team welcome ceremonies will take place for each NOC, where you will be welcomed to the Olympic Village by the village mayor with a flag-raising ceremony.
The feel around the Olympic Village has been absolutely amazing. You know, so many cool people to meet and great energy levels.
We're all just hanging out. We can walk to any event we want to. And yeah, the vibe's been really good. Staying with like a bunch of other cultures and a whole community up in the mountain village was just sick to experience.
Finally, the transport mall at the Olympic Village is where the athletes embark on their journey to greatness, literally. And in PyeongChang, all efforts will be made to ensure the shortest journeys from the villages to competition venues.
On Friday, the 9th of February in 2018, you'll take the stage for the opening ceremony, walking out into a specially designed stadium in the Olympic Plaza, parading with your fellow athletes and representing your country.
It really is a unique experience, and the emotions run high. The world is represented in one stadium, and the billions of viewers from around the world are watching on their televisions and on social media.
The opening ceremonies at the Olympic Games are also an amazing showcase for the host country. In PyeongChang, you'll be able to get a taste of the South Korean culture at its best, with top entertainment, as well as participating in specific Olympic moments, such as the Olympic anthem, the athlete's oath, and the lighting of the cauldron.
That's where all the action will be happening. State-of-the-art competition venues and training venues as well.
After the Olympic Winter Games in Nagano, 20 years ago, where I won my gold medal, this is the first Olympic Winter Games in Asia, and I can tell you, I can't wait for it to begin.
The 13 competition venues are located in the PyeongChang Mountain Cluster and the Gangneung Coastal Cluster. The PyeongChang Mountain Cluster is the site of the Alpensia Biathlon Center for biathlon, the Alpensia Cross-Country Skiing Center for cross-country skiing and Nordic combined, the Alpensia Ski Jumping Center for ski jumping, Nordic combined and big air, the Alpensia Sliding Center for bobsleigh, skeleton and luge, Phoenix Snow Park for freestyle skiing and snowboard, as well as the Yongpyeong Alpine Center for alpine skiing technical and the Yongsun Alpine Center for alpine skiing speed. The Gangneung Coastal Cluster is the location of the Gangneung Olympic Park, hosting ice hockey, curling, figure skating, speed skating, and short track speed skating. Ice hockey has an additional competition venue, which includes a separate training venue, the Kwangdong Hockey Center. There's also a separate training venue for short track speed skating, the Gangneung Yongdong Short Track Training Center at the Gangneung Yongdong University.
As Olympians, we want to support you in complying with two key rulings of the Olympic Charter. Rule 50 has two aspects. The first is to define what is allowed on uniforms and equipment. And the second is to ensure that no propaganda takes place at the Games. Rule 50 has four main goals: to keep the focus on the athletes, to prevent the over-commercialization of the Games and keep Olympic venues, including the field of play, free from advertising by preventing conspicuous advertising on uniforms and equipment, to define the rules for authorized identifications, which include the identification of the manufacturer, and other visible marks on uniforms and equipment to prevent the Olympic Games from being used as a platform to push personal agendas that are linked to unauthorized, commercial, political, religious, or racial propaganda. And number four, to prevent the Games from being used as a platform for protests, demonstrations, and/or the promotion of political, religious, or racial propaganda. Rule 40 is a rule of the Olympic Charter. Its guidelines establish what can and cannot be done by athletes with their image during the period of the Olympic Games. Rule 40 is in place for various reasons, including to preserve the unique nature of the Olympic Games by preventing over-commercialization, to help athletes keep their focus on their sporting performance, to preserve sources of funding, as 90% of the revenues generated by the IOC is distributed to the wider sporting movement. On average, $3.25 million every day goes to the development of athletes and sports organizations at all levels around the world.
Advertisement with your image by Olympic sponsors, covering top partners, rights-holding broadcasters, and your NOC domestic partners, is allowed at any time, subject to your consent. And if you have a sponsor that isn't an Olympic sponsor, then generic advertisement with no link to the Olympic Games is allowed throughout the period of the Games. However, you'll need to apply to your National Olympic Committee for validation. Please contact your NOC for additional information.
Finally, as an athlete participating at the Games, please remember that you are not allowed to bet on any event. If you're approached to manipulate a competition, please make sure to report to olympic.org/integrity hotline or approach an IOC Athlete Commission member. Help us build a clean sport. I've been lucky enough to compete at five Olympic Winter Games. And the moment you first hold your medal is a moment of pure magic. It's unforgettable.
I still remember the victory ceremonies like they were yesterday. The ceremony at the venue was very special. But later, when we took the stage at the Meadows Plaza, the excitement went to the next level. And that's what will happen in PyeongChang.
The Meadows Plaza will be located at the PyeongChang Olympic Plaza, a park entirely dedicated to entertainment for the Games. As well as the victory ceremonies, every evening will host great music, delicious food, and unique live entertainment.
Live sites are a great way for everyone to experience the magic of the Olympic Games. even if they're not lucky enough to get a ticket to the venues. It's also a place for athletes and their family and friends to check out and see the other action. In PyeongChang and across the Republic of Korea, there'll be many live sites to catch the full experience of the Olympic Winter Games.
The main live sites will be at the PyeongChang Olympic Plaza and Gangneung Olympic Park. There'll be live screenings of Olympic action, cultural events, performances and exhibitions, as well as Olympic event tryouts. Throughout February, there'll be fixed live sites in major cities such as Gwangju, PyeongChang and Gangneung, linked to local festivals. There'll also be mobile live sites on a nationwide tour of cities like Busan, Daegu and Incheon.
The games come to a climax with the epic closing ceremony, which will take place as the opening ceremony at the stadium in the Olympic Plaza.
It's time to celebrate with all the other athletes and have a great farewell party, leaving PyeongChang with unforgettable memories.
And so, we come to the end of our film. It's been great to bring back the incredible memories of past Olympic Games as we introduce you to the amazing experience you'll no doubt have in PyeongChang.
We welcome all of you to the 23rd Olympic Winter Games in PyeongChang 2018. We wish you the very best in your quest for Olympic glory.
You're about to make your Olympic dream come true. The magic of the Olympic Games is an amazing experience that will stay with you forever. Wishing you all the best for your preparations, train hard and give it your best in the competitions. See you soon in PyeongChang.